soap star. This guy's paintings now are going all over the country and around the world.
Tonight in this historic event, everybody, Thom Bierdz did this.
Here live, you can see Thom's work through this weekend. His paintings and the variety of styles may catch you off guard.
Hi there, my name is Thom Bierdz. I'm an artist, president of the American Art Awards.
He was one of daytime's rising stars on The Young and the Restless. Then Thom Bierdz suddenly walked away.
He was one of soap opera's biggest stars.
It was 1986. He was on top of the soap opera world.
I don't understand.
Every major soap magazine and thousands of fans wanted a piece of him. But after 3 years, at the peak of his career as Philip Chancellor on The Young and the Restless, a murder in his hometown of Kenosha, Wisconsin, shatters his world.
Bierdz turned to the canvas after a tragedy of his own, a schizophrenic brother who murdered their mom.
She had a problem with me, and she'd say, at first she said, you got a problem with school, you got school for, but she'd tell me what I had a problem with, and okay, you know, you're my mom, I believe you.
She took him to like 40 doctors, and almost all of them said, he's just angry, there's no mental illness here. How can you prove that? He choked a nurse at one point. He escaped psychiatric hospitals. He kept diaries on killing animals and insects, and he wrote satanic poems.
I was in jail at the time. I might have thought of Charlie Manson in the eyes, and went from there. Like I could have went into, you know, you sometimes think that prisoners are cool to each other and everything, and, you know, they'll fight for you, whatever, protect you, maybe like a big guy, a little guy, or just rape or whatever. I used him, and he showed me what to do with this power.
I know that this is my little brother, and there was a while when I forgot that, and I'm very glad that we have this relationship again. And he knows how important he is to me.
The person that forgives is the one that gets the gift, because I thought I was doing her a favor and him a favor, and I was the one that got everything. So, you know, that's what forgiving, you know, is, and I know that.
The paintbrush became Bierdz therapy.
Because it keeps me right in the moment there.
These days, I live full-time in Lake Arrowhead, California, such a beautiful place. As a full-time artist, painting is my passion. So let's get right to showing you these paintings. And intermittently, when it's relevant, there's going to be some more news clips. All right.
I appreciate your eyes on my work. All artists feel vindicated to have their art studied. And you are also seeing my spirit, my beliefs. Even though I have painted my whole life, this particular series is valued at $5,000 a piece because some Bierdz paintings have been selling for that for 10 years since Scarlett Johansson hosted my gallery opening.
Here with Thom Bierdz. Thom, thank you so much for coming in.
Sure, my pleasure to be here.
You are just amazing. Your artwork is phenomenal. It has that impressionist quality to it. Just so wonderful. I know that there are a lot of also, you know, celebrities who are collecting your art.
Mm-hmm. It's true. Many celebrities own Bierdzes, and my very impressive list of collectors is at thombierdz.com. Please check it out.
My latest mission takes place in a world in which millions of dollars change hands every year. The LA art scene. Juan's challenged me to test his security by trying to steal a painting from his gallery. I reveal our target for this job, The House of Doria, a painting by Thom Bierdz, one of LA's hottest young artists. It's exactly the type of thing that thieves would target, because it's only going to get more valuable as time goes by.
My art has also been on occasional TV shows like Hollywood Squares, and my paintings are in my book. My paintings are in 10 of my books. 5 of those are strictly volumes of art. Overall, I've probably got about 1,000 images for prints.
Okay. So, 58. And sir, he said he'd be happy to do another original for 55.
I don't love acting like I love painting, but every once in a while I'm on the set.
The Young and the Restless, our Entertainment Tonight cover story.
And you felt trapped.
In my own skin. That's what I'm talking about. Who am I? You guys don't know who I am.
You don't know who I am.
Put on some clothes, all right? I want to get something to eat before we go to that gallery opening. Hey, baby.
Hey.
Hey, Nathan, how you doing?
Hey, Bobby. Good.
Would you join us for lunch?
No, you know, I've got a lot of...
Looks good.
Oh, well, Bobby.
My brother killed our mom in the kitchen with a baseball bat. So I'm sure this indicates that. He said she was a nag. But I intentionally tried to hide the gravity in this piece. The numbing by overstimulus. That's pretty much why I left Hollywood after 29 years. And now I live in an isolated cabin in the woods painting pictures.
Hollywood lights replaced with Lake Arrowhead trees. Bierdz retreats to what he calls his treehouse and invites me into his home and into his conscience.
I took away the wall and sent this checkerboard into the galaxy, questioning the very existence of material objects. Could this Earth game be nothing more than mind projections? Wow, I've had the honor of working with Jeannie Cooper, one of the soap opera greats.
From The Young and the Restless.
This lady helped me so much. Didn't want to make this just a pretty picture because she was a lot more than just a pretty picture.
Every weekend, 20 years ago, I would fly to different malls in the country and I would sign autographs. They thought I was straight and I wanted them to believe I was straight. I could not tell them that my boyfriend was right there in the audience supporting me.
My brother, who eventually killed himself, was sucked into a very unhealthy relationship.
When Thom's other brother, Craig, committed suicide.
He was sitting on the closet floor. He had shot himself through his mouth in a depression.
He transformed into kind of a rabbit, a scared rabbit, and the gold ropes confining him became this clown mouth, and I added clown eyes and a clown nose, because forcing anybody to love you is such a ridiculous thing.
What gave you the strength to be sitting here today?
I'm gay, and as a young child, sometimes if you're gay, you separate, because...
Sure.
Being raised Catholic, I was told I was going to hell.
Of course.
So you kind of put a distance between you, and you learn to be more of a survivor.
Interesting.
That may be the reason. Oh. Yeah.
I did many paintings trying to capture the peaceful solitude of nature. But I wanted to show here that one could go anywhere. First step is visualizing. I saw a family in this abstract, and I turned it into an illustration of dependency on Western medicine. Very quickly, the top 100 most collectible paintings